I am focusing on the simple linear regressions. The condition to apply single linear regressions, we need a one independent variable, one dependent variable. So please kindly tell anyone which one is independent variable, which one is a dependent variable. In this case, I have the two variable, achievement as well as the study habits. So normally, I may give that in answer itself. So the study habits, based on the study habits, only the achievements level may increase or decrease. Therefore, study habits we may treat as a independent variable. Achievement is a dependent variable. That's why I'm keeping as a criterion variable is a dependent variable. For my case, for this example, achievement is a dependent variable. The independent variable is a predictor that is called study habits. If I know the values of X, I can be able to predict the value of Y. So that is the basics things about the regressions. And therefore, if you have one independent variable, one dependent, we can go with the simple linear only. And you may get this kind of 1, 2, 3. There is a three tables you may get. I'm going to tell the pathway to reach the regression analysis. To reach the regression analysis, first you can go with data. So after opening the particular data sets, go with the data, go with the data analysis. In the data analysis, you can go with regressions. There is a regression. Then click OK. Once you click OK, it has the Y range. So Y is nothing but our criterion variable. It's nothing but our dependent variable. So in this case, the achievement is my dependent variable. Therefore, I am selecting the achievement as a dependent variable. I am selecting all the dependent variable up to B31. Then I am going to select the independent variable. My independent variable is study habits. I'm selecting all the independent variables. Okay, so after selecting all, so kindly check once again. So select the independent variable, select the dependent variable. Then I already select the labels because the headings I'm selecting as the achievement as well as the scores. That is why I'm keeping the labels. And if you need the confidence level as 95%, you can keep it to 95%. Okay, otherwise remove it, and otherwise default is comes 95 only. So in which percentage of level or level of significance you want to keep it, you can keep it. Then output range, but now there is no space in this page. That's why I'm going to generate a new worksheet for output. Instead of this, the same sheets, previously we are going to the same sheets only output, but already lot of answers are available. So that's why I'm skipping to move to the next sheet to generate the output. Therefore, I'm clicking the new workbook. Then you can go with the normality plot test if you need, then line fit plots. Then which are the residues you need, you can go with the residues, like a residue diagram, so you may get it. Then after selecting this much, once again, kindly look on it. First, you have to select the input range, select the input X range, then click the labels. If you need, you can go with the confidence level. Then if you go, I'm going to generate the output in a new workbook. That's why I'm clicking the new workbook. Then if you need to get some kind of residuals in a line diagram based, you can go with which residues you want. Then go with the normal probability class. After selecting this, click OK. Once you click OK, there is a new sheets may generated. There you are getting the entire output. See here, the entire outputs, the entire output, I may get it. Now it's very simple. The same things, the same results may come to the SPSS software or other software also. Even you are getting this some kind of diagram representation. This is for the straight line equation. See here, this is a straight line equation and the straight line that is called line fit. So where the line fit, so you can see from the diagram itself. So this is a line fit. This is a line, the orange color is a line fit of our equations. That is the equation only we are getting into this kind of things. I'm going to do interpretations. So this is the same table, output only comes to here. That's why I'm moving to here. I'm moving to the output once again. See here, this is an output. The first one is a regression statistics output. There you are getting the multiple R, that is called multiple R value, multiple correlation value, then R square value, adjust R square. But here we can check only the R square value. The R square value, our value is 0.732. From this, what is the interpretation in the sense? Taken as a set, the predictor study habits scores account for 73.27% of variance in the achievement scores. So you have to multiply the 0.7327 into 100, you are getting the 73.27%. So what it means in the sense, our independent variable of study habits make an influence or make a predictors. So the predictors of study average scores account for 72.27% of variance in the achievement scores. It may influence nearly 73.27%. So from this, we can check how many percentage of the variance may happen from the independent variable to the dependent variable. So the R square value is important. The second variable, second table is called ANOVA table. Whether your model of the regression is significant or not significant. If it's significant, we can look onto the down table. If it's not significant, no need to be look onto the down table. So that is not needed. So in the ANOVA table, this is called regression. I'm already talking about the ANOVA table descriptions. The same things only SSB, DFB, FSB only. So the F value is nothing but this value divided by this value. So MSB divided by MSW is equal to F value. The same thing, but here in this case, our p value is 0.000. So from this, we can come for conclusion that our p value 0.00 is less than the 0.05 level, as well as 0.01 level. Therefore, it's called significant at both the levels of significance. It means our regression model was significant. Therefore, we can check the below table also. So in this is called APA format. So I'm giving you the APA format. This is called APA format results. This is the manner only you have to write the report also. So just I'm keeping the APA format report. Yeah. So you have to write like this. F1 comma 28 is represent the degrees of freedom. 76.76 it is a F value. Then P value is less than 0.01. R square value is 0.73, and you can highlight this model is significant. Then you can look onto the down table. If it's significant only, you can see the T table. There you can see the intercept value. This is called beta value. So this is called as a constant value. So normally we are telling is an a plus bx, no, the constant value, the intercept value is 15.208. the steady habits, the beta one, so beta one it's called 0.52. so this is called magnitude of the what is that, coefficient of x. So in this case, the steady habits, the t value is 8.76 and the p value is 0.00. it means that your steady habits make a lot of contribution into the dependent variable. It's nothing but significantly contribute. Your independent variable significantly contribute to the dependent variable. That is why the p value is more than it's like 0.00. So from this, we can come for conclusion that the steady habits significant predictors of the achievement score. We have to write the table like this. Beta value is 0.52, t is equal to 28 is equal to 8.76, p value less than 0.01, r square is equal to 0.73. and finally we can write the one equation also. That is equation y. So what is our y? So our y is nothing but our achievement. So our achievement score is equal to what is our constant value? A, 15.20. So because the coefficient value, I'm typing is the coefficient value 15.20 plus what is that beta value? 0.52 times of x1. So what is on x? So it's nothing but x is nothing but our x value. So I'm putting this in x value. So x is here in the case steady habits. So this is the equation. So this is our regression equation. Just I'm going to maximize it. This is our regression equation. Y is equal to 15.20 plus 0.52 times of x. So this is where you have to write the interpretation. This is a line fit diagram. Okay, if you need, you can use this line fit diagram. So just I'm showing only the linear regression, simple linear. Similarly, I'm going to the multiple regression also. See here, there is another data set. I'm using some multiple linear. So you are getting the four variables: achievements, steady habits, attitude, and stress. So in this case, achievement is dependent. Then other three, steady habits, attitude, stress, is to be independent. That's why I put the criterion variable as the achievement. The predictors are steady habits, attitude, and motivation and stress. These are things we may treat as a predictors. It's an independent variable. I already mentioned that If more than two independent variable, in the case of regression, we may use the term as a multiple regressions. I'm going to tell how to do a multiple regressions now. For this, you can go with the data. Previously, I'm doing the simple linear regressions. Now I'm going with the multiple linear regressions. Go with the data analysis, regressions, click OK. You have to select the input Y range. For us, the input Y is nothing but dependent variable, our achievement score. I'm selecting the achievement score. So I'm keeping the cursor in the input Y range. After that, you can select the input range. Then I selected the input Y range. Then I'm keeping the X range. In this case, for me, three X are there. So what is my X? Steady habits, attitude, and stress. Therefore, I am selecting all the three together. So I'm keeping input X range. And after I'm clicking the labels, because I'm selecting the heading also. Then after keeping the labels, I'm going with output range. But this time, instead of output range, I'm going with a new workbook, because there is no space here. That's why I'm going to generate a separate workbook for getting the output. I'm clicking the new workbook. There I'm fixing only the line fits plot, it's a residuals, and normal probability plots. These are the things here to be selected. Then click OK. Once I click OK, immediately I may get the box. Now see here, the entire results. So you are getting the multiple linear in a single click, in a single click. So I may get the multiple linear regressions in a table as the diagram. The same thing, it comes here also. From there, I'm giving the some kind of interpretations. I'm coming with this table. See here, the same tables only come as an output. How we can write the output? The first one is a regression statistics. We have to check the R square value. Here the R square value is 0.8815. If you multiply 100, it gets 88.15. It means that our independent variables make a significant variances, this much of 88.15% of variances in the achievement scores. Like the predictors is nothing but our independent variable. So how we can write the predictors of study habits, attitude, and stress account for 88.1% of variances in the achievement score. It means that much of influences on the independent variable to the dependent variable. So otherwise, that much of contribution to the independent variable to the dependent variable. Then once you having the R square, then you can go down the second table of ANOVA. The second table is talking about the model, whether the model is significant or not. So in this case, the model is significant because the p-value is less than 0.00. If less than 0.0, the overall regression model is significant. Therefore, we can look onto the down table. So this is a down table. This is a table. The second table, the third table. There you are getting the steady habits, attitude, stress. All the three variables are independent variable. Why the stress is minus in the sense, because the stress is a negative variable. It make it a, it's having the some kind of negative relation between the achievement. So because the stress as well as the achievement is a negative relationship. In the case of steady habits as well as the achievement is a positive relationship. Then attitude and the achievement is a positive relationship. That's why the two values, steady habits and attitude, of the coefficient value is positive. In the case of stress only is a negative, because there is a negative relationship happened with the stress of the achievement. And if you look onto the p-value, all the p-value of the steady habits, attitude, and stress, it's less than 0.00. Therefore, it's significant at a 0.05 level as well as 0.01 level. Therefore, we may come for conclusion that the steady habits, attitude, and stress, the three independent variables, are significantly predictors of the achievement scores. So in this manner, we can come for conclusions, and you can write the interpretation like this. You had write the steady habits, beta 1, beta 2, beta 3. The beta 1, beta is nothing but the coefficient value. Beta 2, this for beta 3. Then we may write the equation like this. I mean, going to write the equations. So y, what is our y? Achievement. Achievement is equal to. So I may write once again, y. So y is equal to achievement. Y is nothing but achievement. Is equal to our constant value 53 point, the intercept value 53.64 plus 0.33. I'm taking the only two digits only. 0.33 times of steady habits. steady habits, then plus 0.28 times of attitude, plus we can use it here as a minus because the stress is having the relationship minus, therefore minus of 0.52 times of stress. So this is our equations. So just I'm going to maximize it. So this is our equations. This is called our linear regressions equation. Just I'm maximize it. Yeah, so this is an equation. We have to keep it as a regression equations. So I hope now you understand the simple linear regression as well as the multiple linear regressions. So I hope you don't have doubt at all. So thank you so much.